Hi, boys and girls. How's everybody doing today? I'm really happy that it's sunny out today, not raining like it was yesterday. I got to go out and go for a little walk. My boys rode in the schoolyard on their bicycles for a while, so I hope you're getting out and getting some sunshine today and some fresh air. But right now, I want to talk to you about our letter this week. Does anybody remember what letter it is? That's right, the letter U. So let's see if we can make the letter U. This does not look like the letter U to me at all. Well, maybe this one a little bit because it looks like a hole in the ground like that, right? So if I pull this down and put this right here, there's the letter U. Maybe move it down a little bit more. Now, if I move it this way, do you hear my dog barking? Now he stopped. I never brought my dog to school before, right? So let's put this straight line here and this straight line here. And now we have the letter U. Big U, which is a big hole in the ground. Or it looks like maybe you could put water in it and drink like a cup. And little U. Little U goes like this, a hole and a straight line down. So I hope you've been practicing your letter U and looking for your letter U all around your house and in books and maybe things that start with U. Can you think of anything that starts with the letter U? Unicorn. Have you seen a unicorn? I have. Maybe umbrella. We talked about umbrellas yesterday. I bet you've seen an umbrella. But you know what I was thinking about? I was thinking about something that you all have in your kitchen. These things, knives and forks and spoons, these are called utensils. They start with the letter U. Can you say utensils? That's a very big word. Try again, utensils. Now, we're going to sort the utensils because I'm sure when mommy empties the dishwasher or daddy, or maybe you help, you don't just throw them in a drawer. You have to put the forks with the forks and the spoons with the spoons and the knives with the knives. So we're going to sort them today, and I have this little helpful box that I'm going to use. Here it is. Oh, and they have letters on them. Oh my goodness, look. Do you know what letter this is? That's the letter S. I wonder which thing starts with S. Fork, knife, or spoon? I think it's spoon. So I'm going to put the spoon in the first compartment. That was a loud noise. Now my next letter is an F. Which do you think starts with F? Knife or fork. I think fork. What do you think? Fork, like fish. And four and five and fingers. And our last utensil is the knife. Now it's funny because knife sounds like the letter N for nest and narwhal. That sounds like the letter N to me. But when you're writing the word knife, it actually starts with a K. But the K is silent. So we only hear the N. Knife. That's so silly that it starts with the K, but it sounds like an N, don't you think? Okay, so now we have our spoons and our forks and our knives. So I'm gonna hold up some and you're gonna help me sort them. Oh, there goes my utensils on the floor. Okay, everybody say what this is. It's a knife. Does it go with the spoons? Nope. How about the forks? Nope. The knives have to go with the knives because we're sorting. They're all the same color, they're all silver, but we're sorting by what kind of utensil they are. Okay, let's see. Everybody say what utensil this is. You eat your soup with it, your cereal. It's a spoon. Spoon goes with the spoons by the letter S for spoon. Okay, here's the next one. What do you do with this? Eat your spaghetti and your meatballs. Fork. Forks go with the forks by the letter F. Okay, let's keep sorting. I have another fork. Can I put it with the knives? Well, I could. It goes in there, but I shouldn't because we're sorting. It goes with the forks. Here's another spoon. Where should I put it? That's right, with the spoons. And another fork. And another fork. Oh my goodness, there's so many forks. And spoon goes with the S, spoons. And the last utensil I have is a fork. Now see, they're all sorted in their own compartments. The spoons with the spoons, the forks with the forks, the knives with the knives. Now I thought it would be fun if we could count them. So let's try to count. Here's all my spoons, count with me. One, two, three, four. Four spoons. Let's look at our numbers. Which number is the four? Is it the orange one, the green one, or the yellow one? If you said it's the green one in the middle, you're right. There are four spoons. Now let's count the forks. I remember thinking there were so many forks. Let's count. One, two, three, four, five, six. Six forks. Let me put them back in and see if we can find the number six. Is it the orange one, the green one, or the yellow one? If you guessed the yellow one, then you are right. Six forks. Now for the last one, let's count the knives. Do you remember what letter knife starts with? I remember that it sounds like the letter N, but it really starts with the letter K because it's so silly. Let's count the knives. One, two. Two knives back in their spot. Which one is the number two? Is it the green one? Oh, I just said green and that's orange. How silly of me. Is it the orange one, the green one, or the yellow one? Which is the number two? If you guessed the orange one, then you're right. There are two knives in my container. Now, which one do you think has the most? Which number is biggest here? Two, four, or six? Let's count. Let's one, two, three, four, five, six. If you said six was the most, you're right. There's more forks than any other utensil in my box. There are so many. And which number is the smallest number? That's right, the number two. There are only two knives in my box, and that's the smallest number. Well, thanks for helping me count my utensils today. Now that they're all sorted, I can have a party. Maybe I'll have a company over and we'll have a party. So there we go. Thanks for helping me sort. And don't forget, keep practicing the letter U. See you tomorrow. Bye.